Hi folks, here we are at the amazing Pumpkin Inferno. They have a giant pumpkin display, everything from the Roaring Twenties to a superhero. They have a rock area where they play rock music. 5,000 pumpkins. This is just their first little display as you drive in. Hi everyone. So these pumpkin people here that tell you where the washroom is, when we were first walking in, Emily said she saw some pimp pumpkin people ahead. Apparently these are pimp pumpkin people. So here we are, we made it inside. This is the first pumpkin display. I have to correct myself from the beginning. I told you a bunch of pumpkin displays. What I meant to say was those are what they had last year. They change it up every year, otherwise people wouldn't want to come anymore because who wants to see the same thing over and over again? So yeah, we'll see what they got this year.
So when we first came in, it looks like there's like a scavenger hunt for kids and kids at heart to take part in. And then it has what displays are on this year. The displays change every year, which is kind of fun. They do have some that they keep year round. This is a little bit of fun anyway. And I just wanted to mention too that we came in at an earlier time. There is a lot of kids that come during the earlier hours. So if you're not really into that scene, to come a little bit later, I guess, for the quieter times. But yeah, it's on September and October every year, and it's a lot of fun. It's beautiful artwork done by the locals and the children's schools. So it looks like we're heading into Lover's Lane right now.
So here they have Romeo and Juliet on top of an archway by the looks of it. Oh, it's her balcony. That's what it is. You can even see the rope ladder. Here they have Sonny and Cher. That's what I said. Right here.
You smell the lumber from the lumber mill right
here.
It's Bonnie and Clyde.
Yeah. Here they have Bonnie and Clyde. Hi, Rob. Please don't. Guys, turn a video. Yeah. John back there. Yeah, and then they got Grease Lightning to the right of Elton John. Here's the Eiffel Tower. Yeah, you gotta snap a selfie of that. Here's Martin Luther King. Thank you. Here they have a centaur. Then they have, over here, a female satyr. Yeah, it's a satyr. And then that looks like, supposed to be a vampire. Pretty wicked looking vampire. One of the buffest vampires I've ever seen. And then they have a griffin. Oh, I'm walking into a giant water puddle. On Harry Potter, it's Fluffy, the three-headed dog. I'm trying to think of its real name in mythical lore. Damn, I can't think of it. And then they have a flaming phoenix.
Phoenix is beautiful.
Back there. And then this next one looks like a werewolf. I'm gonna call it Wolfenstein. What? The puddle? Oh! I didn't even notice this, people. They've got like a little puddle pond there so you can see the reflection of a phoenix in the water.
Pumpkins.
Yes, this is all pumpkins. Like this one here is probably at least 20 or more pumpkins. Kind of falling apart a little bit. Oh, that's what it is. I thought it was a werewolf, but yeah, you're right. That's a cyclops. And then they have. Over there. I got Nessie over here. Yeah, this was one of my favorites last year. They've definitely changed it quite a bit by the looks of it. So it starts off with a wizard and a mushroom. And then a fairy. Oh, she's all the way over there. Here I am talking to myself. Beautiful unicorns. Sorry if I go too fast, so I'm gonna come back to that stuff. So this is on the other side. And as Em just pointed out, I'm gonna look up in a second. Because there's a tree right in front of me, which they put pumpkins in to try and look like stars. What's the sign?
Mesozoic era.
This is the Mesozoic era. A T-Rex and a raptor. Love how they try to make it sound or add music for each area to give it a little bit more magic. This is a Spinosaurus.
Yeah, that's a Spinosaurus. Triceratops, T-Rex.
Triceratops, and his raptor on the other side, I'll show you in a second too. And a really nice one, like a pine tree made of pumpkins. Oh, what's that supposed to be?
I think that's just a plant.
Oh, a fern. It's supposed
but
to be a fern.
If you look
okay,
at the tree, it's really cool. You can see like how big some of the pumpkins actually are.
Yeah.
The wider parts of them.
We'll have to see when we get home to see if we can see those pumpkins. My screen is really tiny, so I can't tell if you can see it on the camera. And in here, I did a fern, which would take a lot of little detail to make those.
Is that what that is, a raptor? Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, see the
claws, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
With the, I can't remember what he calls it in.
The talons?
No, there's a name for the one that's on its own.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a specific name for it. It's a really big.
Oh yeah, Brody, he'll show you down.
Fire.
Now they have a fire. They have a picnic table here with
a raccoon.
Oh, there is a raccoon on there. Trash panda. As everyone knows, when you go camping, if you don't secure your food at night.
Yeah, they get into everything. Bandits.
Yeah. Oh, look at that pine tree in the background.
Oh, wow, that's cute. Look at the detail on
that. Be coming around the mountain, she'll be coming around the mountain. Coming around the mountain when she comes. Yeah, so I'm just gonna finish this one and then I'll go up to the the food and all that up there in the mess hall or whatever they call it, canteen. Yeah, I just want to make sure I get this little section.
So we just stopped in at the little cafe and we got a hot cocoa and some water. It's actually quite a beautiful evening out for end of October.
Can
it's
like sip your cocoa?
Yeah, it's just regular hot. Watch him there now.
Yeah.
It's about 20 degrees out right now, which is a little uncommon for Ontario, but it's gorgeous out.
Show them the butler.
Oh yes, I'll show them the butler. So this is the butler. It's heading into the food area. So it looks like he's got like fries and a burger and a shake and maybe something gourmet. Dinner after dark specials. And we actually have some raccoons up in the tree.
Yeah.
Which I really love how immersive the experience is. If you look around everywhere, you'll find something to see.
You're going to show them the detail on the person?
Oh, so yeah, when we were over here earlier, I said to Johnny, like, the detail on some things. Like this woman here has Birkenstocks on, her sandals. I don't know if you guys can see that. And like, the old school boots on the missus in the back there. What are they called? Work boots?
On who?
Like the work boots in the back there. You know the yellow work boots?
No, those are I think they're workers.
So this looks like a bunch of play. If you can look further down, there's actually a mobile display, and it's a little girl swinging on a swing. This is the playground, it looks like. We have a couple kids on a seesaw. And again, the detail in the trees. The trees glittering. Very neat. And jump rope. Blowing bubbles. And look at the little baby playing with the blocks.
And they have a
super cute
fly up on the branch.
Yeah. Oh, the little baby.
I'm gonna say they have a roaring 20s head again.
And a kite again with the trees. This little one over here does not look happy. Not happy at all.
These top Irish ones.
Oh, so we do have the roaring 20s. Nice. So this is the roaring 20s. Which the music is lovely.
I'm sure they had it on the big.
Sorry, hon?
They had it on the big building with the pillars. They've moved it this week.
Yeah. Ooh, martinis. Some of the old. Would they be called gangsters back in the day?
Who?
Like.
That's probably a gangster would use, but I don't see any.
Very cool. Oh, look, they made the pumpkins like she had sequences on her dress. That's really neat.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys can pick up on that on the camera. Very cool. Yeah, the one in the center is the one. We have a bit. The band. Some frapper ladies. Martini glasses.
Stretch my arm, I don't know.
Okay. Oh, the Spirited Speakeasy, that's what it's called. And the bartender in the back there. Yeah. Buddy looks like he got a puffer jacket on.
Kinda, yeah. I think it's supposed to be okay.
Does it smell like the Caribbean?
Nope.
Oh.
It smells like farm animals.
Oh, close enough. Cool. So the next one is Mega Munchies.
A donut here. Looks like a burger next. And a waffle. The waffle. Look at the waffle with the maple syrup. And the fry. And then a popcorn. Oh, I'm walking in a giant puddle again. Good thing I got my blood stones on. Cupcake. Oh, Cauldron Corner Cafe. That must be the evil witch's hideout. And they have little games.
Talk to mom.
They paid pumpkins.
Oh,
Thank you. Where did them go?
Come down on the earth.
Oh, she's taking her selfie. We're back on the side with the waffle. And then it's a slice of watermelon. And I hear rock music ahead. We Will Rock You, to be exact.
Oh, pause you guys and take a picture of the middle one with the cheese.
On your marks, get set, go. Icicle.
I want to ride my
bicycle.
I want to ride my bicycle. I want to ride my bike. I want to ride my bicycle. I want to ride it where I like.
Say black, say white, say box, say bite, say shark, say hey.
Not yet.
No.
Last hole, this last one. Or hotel, or what? The hotel. So this is part of Upper Canada Village. It's the old motel. Oh, it looks like they got a carnival ahead of us. Or a circus. And the clowns are in town. What? Sorry folks, my battery died. I'm back up and rolling. And as Em said, my favorite, and I gave it really loud. So I don't believe in alien in the way that most people do, but I do believe in aliens. They can be in any form. Heck, we could be aliens, for all I know. What I mean by that is they could look like us. You got our next selfie?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know what that's supposed to be. Darth Maul, with the horns and the red and
that's
black face. The satellite and a telescope, as Em says. I couldn't think of the word. I was gonna say periscope, but that's on a submarine. Oh, next one is Jack's Lane. So this is just regular pumpkins. Some of them are pretty cool though, still.
It's true, I guess.
It's up both sides, I'll have to go down one side and back up the other. You hear me, Em? Em? Okay. I'm gonna go down one side and back up the other. Let's slow down so you can see these actually. If you see any that you like, wait for me and point it out. Oh. This is, this is Halloween from Night Before Christmas, the music. A troll.
A troll or fatso or something. That's pretty neat. They're all pretty interesting. I wonder if there's any Harry Potter. Last year they had a couple of Harry Potter shows. Oh, there's, what are those masks called?
An Oni mask.
Yeah. It's pretty dark though.
Yeah, the middle needs to be carved out a bit more. I don't even know if you can see it on the camera. Anybody that knows what an Oni mask will be able to see it, I think.
Yeah.
That's what I want for one of my next tattoos, as Em knows. Oh, the big wide mouth up there?
Yeah.
That's from a movie. The cat does that.
The Cheshire Cat?
The Cheshire Cat, yeah.
Well, that's Alice in Wonderland.
That is my favorite.
Now we're going back up the other side to come back through again. Because they've got them up both sides. Oh, is that right there? Oh, that's more like a vampire bat. Baby's got the bat nose. See the curled nostrils like a bat has?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. The wind, right?
I can't really tell what that one is.
What do you mean?
That little one right there on the corner. I'm trying to figure out what it's supposed to be. No idea. Oh yeah, a little Mrs. Casper. Oh, do you see the one with the mustache?
No, where?
Right here.
Oh, right there, yeah.
Oh, someone did, anybody on the internet, if you know what it is.
Oh, it's, from Monsters, Inc.
Oh, yeah, it's,
it's the eyeball dude. Not the blue guy, the other guy.
Sully? No, Sully's...
Sully's the blue guy, it's the other
Mike.
Guy.
Mike.
Yeah. One
Mike
of them.
From Monsters, One Inc. Couldn't think of the name. So this is our next area. Oh, they got Dracula's mugshot. Is it a mugshot that we need, babe?
No, it's
okay.
I guess the sign, it's like a picture.
Dracula. They put a big gap there. They could have put one on this side, eh?
That's all water there.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, we're going down to where they could get the boat.
Or they could, I don't know, because there's a big gap between Dracula and...
Oh, I know what you're saying, yeah.
You feel better?
Rob Zombie?
Deadly bite.
And his name is Rob, so and he looks like a zombie, Rob Zombie. Rob Zombie.
Yeah, that's Rob Zombie.
Feel better? Oh, they got Medusa next. Well, this is one I'm gonna have to go up one side and then do the other side again, babe.
Yeah.
Just so you know what I'm doing.
Stoning.
She does turn people to stone.
Yeah, Medusa. That's like that commercial now. Right?
What commercial?
She has to get sunglasses or something because if she looks at her lover...
Or like Ray-Bans or something?
I don't know. I can't remember what it is.
I don't remember
either. But it's a commercial and she gets like sunglasses. She's a werewolf. She doesn't turn people into stone. Disturbing the peace.
Because he howls all the time. Get it?
Indeed.
Is that a cyborg group? No, because it's only 5-4.
That's a different one. Cyberbullying. Yeah, nobody likes cyberbullying. Yeah, exactly. Exactly, little.
And then they have mummy. Oh.
I know, but last year we came.
Removing a bandage in public.
Oh, look at the evil eye down there.
Yeah, the,
cool.
Damn it, I know this. I don't remember what it's called.
It's called an evil eye.
Yeah, but there's a scientific name, too. Isn't there?
I'm not sure.
Bride of Frankenstein. Crime. Accomplice. This is our next one. And M just informed me I gotta back up and look up. Yep. So it looks like they have the biohazard symbol, a caution, electricity. I have no idea what molecule that would be. It's
a hydrocarbon.
Hydrochloric acid?
Yeah, maybe.
Because carbon is an acidic.
Yeah, it could be
when mixed with hydrogen,
all you smart people out there.
I think.
Chemistry nerds.
Should know more of this where I work.
Yeah, well.
But I'm just a laborer, so. That's pretty cool. All the scary scholars. Oh, it's all the mugshots.
Yeah,
okay. I just noticed that just before he said it. And then looks like it's supposed to be a beaker that's overflowing. I'm assuming that's supposed to be Dr. No. Oh, maybe. Or I was thinking Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe. He looks like what's his face from Back to the Future.
Oh, he does too.
A little bit.
That's okay, I can get over you.